Hi, here at the editorial staff, a tremendous chaos arose. My colleagues and I are all desperately looking for sources, in and outsiders, to get you all updated about the latest developments within this crisis. The most important thing is that the blockade, which was stated by John F. Kennedy in his latest speech, has started today. This quarantine line, where the ships from our country are located, is trying to pull back the ships from the USSR, which are transporting the missiles, which could eventually destroy our country. No ship can enter or leave Cuba anymore, and every attack from Cuba would be seen as an attack of the Soviet Union. That was what our president said. We don't know what's going to happen next, but for now we are holding our breath. It's a fact, after all, that the world has never been this close to a nuclear war. So we will have to wait to know what our near future will look like. Wait, there's someone on my line now. Hello? Is there any news from Cuba? Yes, I see. Well, thanks a lot for this brand new information. And I'm back on track again. I just received an anonymous call. It seems like Khrushchev sent a letter to John F. Kennedy. He proposed that he's willing to remove the Soviet missiles and personnel if the USA will say black and white that we will not invade Cuba. The same source told me as well that it was exactly the response Kennedy was hoping for.
Welcome to CNN Breaking News, live from New York City. My name is Joy Farberg. Today, Khrushchev sent another letter to our president. This letter does not only look more professional than the first one, his demands have grown as well ever since. The security that Cuba would not be invaded was not enough anymore. He also wanted some more security for himself. He required that the missiles the USA located in Turkey, which are able to attack Russia, would be removed. The missile sites from both countries would be able to ruin their most important cities. So we would say, just sign this agreement. But is this really as simple as it seems? We ask it to Fleur Thingenies, who is at our editorial staff.
If everything was this easy, there would never have been a Cold War in the first place. The reason that this agreement cannot be signed as easily, at least not publicly, is because Turkey would feel unprotected when the missiles are removed, which could lead to even more problems. Despite that fact, Kennedy and his advisors are unsure if Khrushchev is still the one in control. These doubts arose because the second letter looked so different than the first one. He might have been overthrown by someone of the government. I also picked up some very interesting information, which I might not be allowed to tell, but which I will anyway. What I heard is that Kennedy sent a secret message to Khrushchev, saying that he would remove the missile sites in a few months, but that it was kept secret so the public would not know, especially Turkey. But thanks to our well-informed sources, there are no secrets which can stay unknown for long. To cover the secret message, he also sent an original one where he agreed with the conditions demanded in the first letter. Tomorrow, the 28th of October, Radio Moscow will announce this news as well, and the 1st of November the missiles will be removed. This crisis has been from 24 until the 10th to 28th of October, and no real winner can be appointed. And now back to the studio.
It seems that we have reached the end of the red threat, which means a nuclear war is not so likely anymore as it was before. Thank you all, and good evening.
and some American companies were taken over by that. This the USA made this... What? Is that a wrong text?
Actually.
Oh, I'm going to boil. Oh, die jongen is zo lach.
Zo lach.
Hey, hallo, mijn boer.
Kut.
Je ziet je hand. Je ziet echt zo tegen, yes.
This made the USA decide to break off some... Break off the economy... Zit in mijn keel. After John F. Kennedy's speech from 2 days ago, in which he demanded to the Soviet Union to remove flick off ears. Moest jij
het zeggen? Nee, jij moet. Die hebben we al lang gedaan, toch?
Kan het zeggen?
Oh, dan is die...
Terwijl bij die Eisenhower, dat zei ik nog.
Jij moest beginnen. Ik heb al kei veel gedaan.
Jij moest bij deze beginnen.
Mijn linkerhand tapt mij niet uit of een potlood. Want dat staat wijs. Want ja, ik ben wijs. En elk verhaal begin ik met een mooi monoloog. Want er zijn al te veel mensen op tv die er niets van bakken. Voor ik blijf vooral bescheiden, maar als ik mezelf had kunnen kussen, had ik dat gedaan.
Even wachten. Ik zeg wel ja of zo.
This letter does not only look more professional than the first one. It's the best.
Hallo, maar de boer is al lachen.
Geweldig.
Hey, poes, vind je cybersex? Dat vind ik ook zo'n hoogtepunt, meid. Poes, never mind.
Oké, okay, hoe maken we dit langer?
Dat moet Patrick al weten.
Wil je nog aan je puttetje?
No, yes. I hope we all informed you. Laat maar.
Ja. Dus. Lekker.
Ha ha ha!